there are three things that remains: faith, hope, and what? Love. But the greatest is love. Let me tell you, anybody that carry the agape love of God, you have no choice but to become like the greatest. You have no choice but to become what? The greatest. So Paul was saying that there are different ways to get into a particular thing. There is a place of faith and it's a place of hope. But I said, let me show you from the other, because if you read the chapter 12, don't forget, we read the chapter 10. If you read the chapter 12, Paul was talking about spiritual gift. Hello? Spiritual gift. And they spoke about prophecy, they spoke about a lot of things. And then Paul came and said, let me now show you a more excellent way, because I can use prophecy to get something, I can use power to get something, I can use my intellect to get something, I can use my appearance to get something. But let me tell you people, let me show you a more excellent way. It's the way of love. Hello? You can use your smart mind to get something from someone, but it is better if you use your love. I pray in the name of Jesus that we will be shown the most excellent way in our life. In our business, may we be shown the most excellent way. In our marriage, may we see the most excellent way. In our family, may we see the most excellent. In this ministry, may we work in the most excellent way. Hallelujah, man. And Paul said, he said, if I speak in tongues, not just from food, but if I speak in tongues of men and tongues of angels, and I have no love, I am what? I am what? I am nothing. Let me tell you. You can be the most powerful tongue talker in this church. When we say, let's begin to tattoo my life, yes, sir. If we give him a home, give him a new one, sir. You speak in tongues like Archbishop. Let me tell you, if there's no love in your heart, Bible, it's not me, you are nothing before God. Maybe in the eyes of men, you are spiritual, but to God, you are nothing. One day people will get to heaven and they will tell God, God, we prophesied in your name. And God will tell them, Master, forget about that prophecy. And so, oh God, I spoke, I mentioned the person hometown. I even mentioned the phone number. I was not lying. And God said, get it behind me. When I was sick, did you visit me? When I was hungry, did you give me food? These are the show of love. Let me tell you, in this end time, if there is anything that you must hold on to very well, it's a recipe of love, because that is what will open the gateway of heaven for you to enter. That's what opened the gateway. I know gifted people. I know many gifted people. Many. Yesterday, by the grace of God, the whole chairman of Fountain Gate International Church came here. He came here. When he came, we entered the office. We came here. He came to check things. And I'm talking about a heavy man. I don't know if you know him. A heavy man. When you talk about the Church of Ghana, they are the fathers. When he came here, I look at something and say, hey, this man, because of what this man has done, I have no reason to hate people. Because, say, baby, I think there is a son of his own. I was a car, man, and yet children. He drove himself, he left him, but he came here. And he came and prayed for me and left. This one is not offering. I said, it's not the offering I'm giving him. It's not anything. It's a pure show of love for a young guy that is coming out, that does not know left and right, and he said, I want to help this guy. So as I also